2 today. It's a game that is very, very nice. If you've never played it, then please stick around and maybe you'll love it. You never know. So we're going to be playing some single player. We're going to be playing a very special mode. We're going to be playing Tactician, which is the hardest, and we're going to be playing Honor, which means you can't go back. It's like hardcore. If you die in the game, you die in real life. Failure is not an option. And we're going to be doing this, and we're going to see how far we can go using just one dude. Just one dude. That's all we're doing. So we're going to see how well this works out. I'm going to check. Audio sounds good. We're going to hit accept. And we're going to jump right into it. Unfortunately, I can't have a webcam on for this game because it takes up a lot of space. So I have to have it on an external hard drive. So janky, I know. But yeah, the external hard drive takes up the slot that normally the webcam would fill. So unfortunately, no, nothing for us today. All right, let's go ahead and choose our characters. So we're going to be doing, there's a lot of different options. We're going to be doing Elf because they have this ability, Flesh Sacrifice, which increases their damage by 10%, which is just amazing on its own. And you gain an action point. So this can be very handy in a pinch. But also, they have the ability to eat corpses, which gives a slight ability as well. So we're going to be playing the Witch preset, but we're going to be changing that up a little bit. I don't care about the appearance so much. The name is going to be Doug Azeder, of course. The presets, we're going to go with Down on Finesse. Actually, yeah, we're going to keep those stats. I think that's fine. But what we're going to do here is instead of this, we're going to go with this. Yes. So we have Chloroform, Backlash, and Mosquito Swarm. Maybe we want Bloodsucker instead of Backlash. It's a big decision. I kind of need some form of healing. I guess I already have Mosquito Swarm, but another form of healing would be very nice. We're going to keep these, except for you. You're going to go to bartering. Are you? I might just literally do exactly what's preset as a witch. It's a big decision. Bartering or persuasion? Do we need more money or do we need more stuff? I just said both things that go to bartering. Do we need more money, or do we need more people to do what we want them to do? I mean, persuasion does kind of make you barter, too. We're not going to do leech, that's for sure, because we have the ability. Instead, we're doing lone wolf, because this guy is literally going to be alone. So if I didn't do lone wolf, then that'd be pretty unfortunate. We're going to go with the cello, because I play the cello in real life. And we're going to confirm and head straight into the game. I'm going to let this play for a little bit. I'm going to check the audio to see if you guys can still hear me.
It all happened like I knew it would. A single drop of sauce. Flies to honey.
Alright, looks like you can still hear me.
The rebel panicked. The carnage began. And the magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned.
Yeah, just as she had planned.
I was shackled and collared.
Totally believable.
And sent to Fort Joy.
Oh my god, there's all the characters that we were able to play. I'm gonna move my mouse out of the way so it's not taking up all this space.
I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
Wow. Divinity Original Sin 2. Definitive Edition. So nice. Dude, this game kind of slaps, if I'm being totally honest. This game, like, hardcore slaps. So excited for this. Alright. What up, Magister Swain? Excuse me if I end up going through a lot of the text. I kind of don't care. Sometimes I care, but sometimes I just don't. So sometimes I'm just going to end up doing it. And if that's something that you need, then I'm sorry. I thought, is there a rope or a bucket over here? Nope. Okay. We're going to come over here, and we're going to do a little loop. For that is exactly what we are set up to do. Going to go through this door. So if you've never played Divinity before, then this game must look so cool to you. If you've ever played D&D, then it's basically the same thing, except instead of having a single dude telling everything that happens, you are playing online, so it doesn't really, you know, it doesn't affect you too much that there's a dude playing. So you can play with four friends. And you know what? I said that in a very weird way. I will 100% take that as my mistake, because I said that in a very weird way. So you can take up to four friends, and you can play this game. And, yeah, it's just like D&D, where you're going around, and you can do whatever you want, and you just try your best to do what you want to do. So right now, what I want to do for this run, I don't know. I think what I'm going to do is end up being like, jeez, I don't know. We're going to definitely be a pickpocket, because that's, you know, there's a lot of movies that say have that stereotypical character where pickpocketing is like the only way forwards in the world. But it's actually true here. Pickpocketing is literally the only way forward in this world sometimes. So we're going to go ahead and just be okay with that. And whatever. We're going to whisper to guard. We're going to persuade him with constitution. Yeah. And then we're going to persuade him with intelligence. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come over here. And we're going to open this door. And then that's going to trigger a fight. Whoa, why are you fighting me? Well, that's unfair. Jeez, thanks for sparing me. You hit literally everybody except for me. What a kind guy. Look at him go. Alright, we're gonna start off with a little bit of flesh sacrifice, increasing our damage by 10%. That's a lot. That is quite a bit. I'm sorry, but that is a lot of damage. We're going to hit that guy with a mosquito swarm. We're going to hit him once. We're going to chloroform that dude. And we're going to finish off that guy. Alright.
And I can.
Oh, I've played this tutorial a couple times, so I already know that this guy tries to kill us. Maybe a little bit of an advantage, but what can you do? Sometimes it just happens. We're going to heal up a little bit. And we're just going to slap a bitch. How do I have so many action points? What the heck? Where did I get them from? Okay. Whatever. I guess we take it. Dude, chloroform? What's your cooldown? 3? I guess I was out of combat for a turn. That's sick. Mosquito swarm has a cooldown of 3 as well. Alright, we're gonna chloroform him. I mean, this fight is not that interesting. It's kind of already confirmed to us what's gonna happen here. I mean, this is the whole reason of taking extra action points and extra damage. Because you want to be able to win 1v1s and also every other fight, so. We easily get this. What are we getting? Bloodsucker? Whatever. Oh, but we do get blood sacrifice or flesh sacrifice, so we're getting even more whammages. Heal up a little bit, so this guy just literally cannot touch us. And hit him a couple times. This fight is a marathon, it's not a sprint, but we're making it through. Alright, let's see. Let's finish him off with the mosquito swarm. That way we finish off at full health. Dude, that fight, so easy. What you got? You just got a key. I can't take your sword, I can't take your outfit, none of that. You just have a key. Of course. Let's go through here with the newly found key that I have. So, loot all these. This room has a ton of loot. This is a nice room. So we're going to go ahead and loot it all and be happy. One of the biggest things in this game, as with all RPGs, is health potions. You never have enough of them. So I'm glad to be starting off with a few extra. Especially since we're doing a one-person run, it's going to be extremely hard. Oh, I accidentally clicked off. I didn't even know that was possible. Doesn't do anything for you guys, though, thankfully. All right. We're just going to brute force our way through this door. We're not going to try to do anything crafty. Door kickers. All right. I don't think there's much in this room. I'm not going to lie, from what I remember. There's this lever. We can hit that. And we can move on with our lives. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to leave the tutorial deck and enter the real world. Look at me go, Pappy. You pick up the golden cup because you can sell it for quite a bit. You pick up whatever you can. I mean, the limit for what you can hold is extraordinarily high in this game. So usually you don't have to sweat it. Usually you're totally fine. Alright. We didn't get too lucky. We didn't get all that much stuff, but we did get a little bit of gold there. Not that it matters too much. I mean, a little bit of gold. That's like nothing. Alright, we tried to steal it, and that was an accident, so whatever. Now we're in a conversation with this person who's telling us that we're the scum of the earth, and I'm gonna be totally honest with you, I don't care. Alright, we're gonna not do that. We're gonna come in here. So one thing that you always want to do if you're trying your best to do well, and you're doing like a one-person run, so it's very hard, is before everything in this first little encounter, you want to barter with everybody because that loads their items so that when they all die in... Spoiler alert. When they all die, you end up getting more items out of their body, out of their looted corpse. So isn't that pleasant? Pick up the bedroll, and we're going to go ahead. I like to have my bedroll all the way over there, just because, I don't know, it looks nice, kind of. And we're going to move on. We're going to open every barrel, every crate, and we're going to be looting everybody. Everybody that is going to die. Every magister. Everybody is... Oh, that's a shirt that gives me armor. We're totally going to take that. Equip. We're going to come over here, loot this guy. Oh my gosh. I could have started a fight there, huh? Maybe. Who knows? Can't barter with the dog. Sad to hear it. I think we come over here. We grab bottles of beer, of course. We want to be able to get absolutely hammered at any time we want. Can we come over here? Grab these bottles of beer. How many beers are on the wall? That's always a question. All right. Let's come over here. There's always a ton of food back here that we're going to be able to steal. I don't get why the magisters let us just freely walk in here and steal literally everything, but hey, I guess I'm not complaining. They see you and they're like, oh, he's just up for a midnight snack. What's the worst that could happen? I don't even know if it's midnight, but that's the story and I'm sticking to it. Some mashed potatoes. Gotta have the small poison bottle. I don't know what it's for. Or I don't know if it actually is going to help us out. But it's gotta at some point. If you know what I mean. Alright. Dude, I'm very slow. I could pick up those bedrolls, which are worth quite a bit. But I also could not do that. And that's exactly what I'm going to end up doing. I'm totally fine, dude. Don't even worry about me. Don't even sweat it. I'm straight J, chilling. Let's do this. Let's have this interaction where she ends up being an absolute bitch. And kills everybody around us. I mean, come on. It was the first fight. I wanted to play the first fight. You know? Oh, frick. I can't say you know. Snap, we just got roofied. Let's pick up the red snapper. Cheese bread. Ham. Bottle of wine. Bottle of wine. Bottle of wine and some pumpkin soup. These guys, I did not try to barter with them. So they're going to have, like, literally nothing. 3 golden log. That's the most that I got from one of these guys. Keep track of that. Let's come back in here. And first guy, I bartered with him. Boom, that's a ton of stuff. All right, this guy right here, I bartered with him. Nope, this is the dog. Gotta hide from the dog. This guy, boom, ton of stuff. Tons. Oh, Namaya, I should have bartered with her, but I ended up not doing that. Oh, well. Grenade. Boom, tons of stuff. It's crazy. As soon as you barter, it's like everybody is your best friend. Coming up here. Loot this guy. Boom. Tons of stuff. Boom. Oh my god, a knockback arrow? Or knockout arrow? That's crazy. Dude, watermelon? Maybe crazy? I don't know. We're gonna come over here. And, we're gonna rough her up.
The magister lies on the floor.
She kind of made me hate her, so we're going to rough her up like nobody's business. We're just going to see her on the ground and keep smacking her right in the vagina. Damn. All right. I love how brutal this game is. I get 100 XP from that, but the biggest thing is I get a water arrowhead, so we'll take it. Let's move on. To these stairs right here. You know, the tutorial in this game, I like it. It's a very nice way of introducing you to the game. Yeah, you have the option of looting whatever you want, and that's just like in the real game, funny enough. And it's, I don't know, it's just very nice. Gonna take this chest. And we're going to open this one. And I wonder if we have the key to this. Maybe we do. But first of all, we're going to end up doing a little bit of that and a little bit of this. We're going to vary them. Because why not? Do we not? All right, we don't have a key. It doesn't matter. The door only has 30 health. We're fine. The dog is straight up out of here. We're gonna come open this chest, and yep, that's good. Now what we're gonna do here is we're gonna end up persuading them that we are good guys. Hello, welcome to the good place. If you've ever watched that. All right, we can't butter with him, but oh wow, we can't butter with any of them. Anyways, all of that, oh, an absolute waste. because we're just going to end up fighting them anyways. I mean, I need the experience. In this game, you need the experience. It's not even something that you can take for granted. That's not what I wanted. All right, we're going to go ahead and make sure I can finish this guy off, because that's kind of annoying. We definitely can't die to him. All right, 100 XP. We're already off to a great start. There's a ton of blood around us, so I'm not sweating it too much. I think we're going to be able to heal like 50. Let's see what it actually is. Well, it's just 12. I was very much so off, but I also expected that to happen. What do you do? 7 to 8. We're going to hit him once, and I think we're going to run. We're going to hit him again. Now we're going to run. Because we want to take away his action points. Yeah, now he has to walk to us, and he gets to hit us one last time. Boom. Now we get to mosquito swarm him. And we're straight up doing fine, I think. I think we kill him here. Yeah, boom, boom, kashawa. Oh, frick. That's not at all what I meant to do. But it's what ended up happening. Let's see if I end up dying here. All right, I think we got to pop a pot. And we're just going to face check this guy, because there's not much else we can do here. He does not seem to want to die. I think we're going to have to all out him here. Let's see what happens. I don't think I've ever ended up having the dog in this fight. So what we're going to do is we're going to hit this guy. We're going to hit him up, ask for those DMs. Kind of weird, but you know. I mean, kind of weird that it's a dog, but you know. And then we're going to chloroform him. After sliding into those DMs, we chloroform him, we abduct him, we put leeches all over his body, and we realized that we should have had a flesh sacrifice before we did the leeches, but no matter, the sacrifices must go on. We're going to go ahead and regret that entirely, but we've already committed, so we're going to go all in and hope that he ends up not killing us. He didn't. But he also ended up saving some, so I hope that I end up killing him here. Oh, I did. Just 25 experience. All right. To be honest, I didn't want to fight the dog, because that's, I mean, morally, would you fight a dog, even if it was coming at you? Yeah, I would. But morally, would you want to? No. Obviously, the frick not. That's just insane. Don't even talk to me about that. I wouldn't want... Did I just pick up a diaper? That's not disgusting at all. All right. Where are we going? We're going all the way up here just to loot this guy right here. Fair enough. You know what? We take it. If that's what you want us to do, whatever. That's what you want us to do. We're going to use our key on the door to open it up. And we're going to not die to the squid tentacles. Alright. Taking this. This is probably the scariest part, because I could lose like 30 minutes with one wrong step. There's nothing on that guy. All of that risk for no reward. But I did get a sword. I'll take the sword. All of you are empty. You're empty. You're empty. We're coming over here. We're looting this chest. Dude, 2 gold. Gonna save our lives one day. I mean, that's how serious it gets when it comes to 2 gold. Gonna keep on moving around and taking what we please. We're at wedding crashers, and this is the wedding of a lifetime where everybody's drunk and probably passed out. But, and I mean, some of them may be dead. But if we report them to the authorities, then we're the ones who end up getting screwed. So, you know. We can't do that. Oh, I'm already mad at myself because I didn't end up using my bedroll. But we'll see if that ends up not being too bad for us. We're going to flesh sacrifice. We're going to mosquito swarm. We're going to chloroform. And we're going to go ahead and heal up what we can. And we're going to end our turn with an extra. And that's fine. Maybe I should have moved one away. Actually, that's totally what I should have done. But it's too late now. He doesn't get an attack He does not get an attack of opportunity. So what we're going to do is we're going to come back here and we're going to just backstab him a ton of times. Wish he was dead. Sometimes you don't get that privilege. He poisons himself. We take it. All right, let's kill off this guy. He had exactly one health. You hate to see it. And start on this guy, and this fight is already over before it even began. We're going to heal up by attacking him. Boom. And then what we're going to do is we're going to fall asleep right there with the bedroll. Oh my gosh, I love that. I love that the bedroll lets you fall asleep literally anywhere. All right. Come over here, loot this, and we're going to end up coming up here. We do it. We end up doing it. It's worth. Because we want the wand, which is worth a little bit of gold. We want the wand, which is worth a little bit. Nice little anthem I got there. Alright, that's good enough for me. Hopefully we don't die to the fire. Did we not get a wand? Alright, damn. No, the improvised wand is right there. It's on the floor, it's not on them. Okay. Let's go. Come on, vamanos. Nope, that song is most likely copyrighted. So that actually wasn't a song. I just said, come on, vamanos. I was just trying to reach out to more Spanish-speaking people. These guys are absolute cowards. We're going to go back and save these people. Even though we can't, we're not going to team up with any of them, we're still going to save them. Because otherwise, that's kind of rude, you know? Oh, snap, I said it. I said, you know. Alright, that's the wrong one to use. We're gonna do this to you. Nope, first of all, we're doing flesh sacrifice. I remembered this time. Alright, flesh sacrifice. We're coming over here. We're eating him up. And then we're gonna chloroform this guy. And that's all of the input that I'm going to give. We're going to come and pick up this 4 gold. And these guys should be able to clean up everything else. And I should still get the XP for it. You gotta love it when that happens. We're almost to level 2. Almost halfway there. Wait, are we halfway there? 9 to 25. Yeah, we're not halfway there. 75 off of halfway there. This person ends up stealing our strat, getting the backstab critical. Whatever. I'm not mad. I'm just disappointed. Where are you going? What? Oh, you're going in the middle of everybody to encourage everybody? Sure. Okay. Los. I forgot that name. That's a really cool name. Is it actually going to get around to be my turn? Oh my god, is Losa going to die? No way. Yeah, she pops a heal potion. She's fine. She's fine. She just pops a heal potion and she moves on with her day. And then she shocks both of the people and doesn't get shocked herself. That's the most impressive thing I've ever seen. I do believe. Nice, nice. When am I going to get a turn again? I'm sorry. Oh my gosh. Hey, what did I say? What did I say? I said we were never going to get a turn again. And what just happened? We never got a turn again. You know, I just realized I got an arm in here. All right, where are you? There you are. Chunk of flesh. We're going to eat you up. And we're going to gain adrenaline. It's just that easy sometimes. Boom, level up with a little bit of experience left over. I don't think that, yeah, you have to do literally everything in order to level up. And I had 25 experience left over. So that's pretty cool. You know, honestly, not scared. I'm gonna be totally honest. That thing, not scary. I've got literally God looking out for me.
I have plans for you, John.
See, look at that. Literally God. He's looking out for me.
Honorable Dennis.
Oh my gosh.
We lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity. High Judge Orivan.
Wow, thank you for that little bit of backstory. Pretty cool. Let's get going to my favorite part of a one-man run. It's called the puzzle part. Because when it comes to Fort Joy, there's a limited amount of ways to get experience. And you need to be, since as a lone person, you usually need to be at least one level higher, if not more, in order to win any fights. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to pick up memory so that we can fit adrenaline into our skill set here. Then we're going to pick up some more strength so that when it comes to that guy with the spear, we can go ahead and just nab it off of him. Over here, we're going to put a point into, I'm not sure yet. We're going to wait on that. It might be retribution. Over here, we're going to put a point into thievery. And that's where we at for level two. Thievery, obviously very important so that I can end up getting whatever items I want. I mean, I guess whatever item I want is obviously a huge overstatement, but I do want quite a few items. There he is. I was wondering where he was, but he's a little bit ahead of where I am. I kind of messed up this fight with that engagement. Rather than hitting them first and still having full action points, I ended up not doing that. So we're going to go ahead and fight this fight anyways. Chloroform that dude. And we're just going to back up. We're going to back it up. If I back it up, is it fast enough? There we go. And we're going to wait for them. All right, dude. You do you. If you really want to heal that badly, go ahead. I'm just going to sit here and wait for y'all to come to me. I'm going to go pick up this seashell, and then I'm going to loot this crate. And I'm going to read this book in the middle of a battle, and then I'm going to pick it up. This game is so funny sometimes. Are you bleeding? Oh, you're bleeding. Because of the mosquito swarm. Oh, I get it. I get it. You had enough action points to hit me? All right. I respect that. I mean, it's totally fine, though, because you're not going to end up coming anywhere near defeating me, but you know, that's still pretty impressive. 100 free experience, that's nice. This guy moves right past me, doesn't have a care in the world for who I am. I'm going to go ahead and show him why he should know my name, and maybe he's going to rethink moving past me in the future. That's so goofy. Pobre Magister Jaline. Yo, we get a resurrection scroll to sell later on. I mean, that's all they're worth, if I'm being totally honest. It's a bunch of resurrection scrolls. Scrolls are just worth selling. And we get Sir Laura. I have no idea what he does, but I'm hoping he's pretty cool. Let's move on. What's our wits at? Probably pretty low. I don't think I... Yeah, it's the one stat that I haven't upgraded, so we're not going to be able to find anything out here. That's all right. We're gonna be fine. I still haven't figured out what I want here, and I think what I'm going to take is probably... Do any of these give me dodge? Dual wielding, yes. That's exactly what I want. Plus 5% damage and plus 1% dodge. All right. I think we're going to take this over Necromancer. Right? Let me just convince myself there real quick. We're going to think about it for a little bit longer. It doesn't matter too much what we actually have. Because once we get to the mirror, we're going to actually figure out what we need. But, I mean, in Fort Joy, it's really difficult sometimes to get out. Like, I mean, you've got to play it semi-perfectly sometimes. So that's what we're going to try to do. Is play this semi-permanently. Perfectly. Alright. But Shovel is an easy catch, so we can open up this and obviously equip that amazing leather armor. I don't think we're going to pick up the bow yet. We might end up doing bow in the future. And that's why I hesitate to put in points into dual wielding, because I don't know if I'm actually going to keep them there. We're going to visit this guy. Visit an old friend. We're going to loot this dead human on the ground. We're going to not talk to that guy because I don't give a freak. And I cannot get this chest. I cannot kill those turtles. So we move on. Yeah, there's no way I'm killing those turtles. They're just too powerful for me at this moment. But it's all right. I'm going to be building up my power. I'm going to be like Goku. No, I'm going to be like Saitama. I'm going to slowly gain power until I'm literally unkillable. What am I looking for? HL. I don't know. C. Nope. I literally move. Oh, there's the cat. B. G. Y. I'm looking for freaking memories. L. What was M? J. K. Oh, it's K. Okay. Oh, I didn't even have to get memory. I still had an extra slot. Well, maybe that's going to be a big mistake in the future. But for right now, whatever. It's a tragedy to watch. Yes, indeed. But sometimes it just happens. 300 free XP. I mean, I'll watch a tragedy for 300 XP any day of the week. I tell you. Any day of the week. I wonder how much 300 XP is worth in real life. I wonder if I could sell it as an NFT. Oh my gosh. Here we go. Magister Atusa gives us that juicy leg that we absolutely need. We're going to barter with you. Take our leave. We're going to barter with you. And then take our leave. And we're going to come over here and we're going to talk with some twerps. I think if we span one, we're all set. Yeah. All right. So we're going to not follow her because that actually ends up killing the cat. It's a very sad story. But what we are going to do... Oh. We're going to really wish we put our points into wits. I think we're going to be fine, but we're going to really wish we had. We're going to come down here. We're going to gain the experience from that. 300 free experience. We're going to come over here. We're going to go in this cave right there. That cave right there. And we're going to get the free experience from going in there. And then we're going to come over here. We're going to talk to her. We're going to finish that one for another bunch of experience. We're doing it. We're speed running Fort Joy. We're going to come here and we're going to go ahead and follow him over to his place and cut him. Now we're going to follow him back to the other place. But before I do that, I'm going to talk to Elodie, whatever.
Thank you.
And we're going to say... We're going to say some stuff so that we can get what we want. I guess we go with the shank here for a little bit of extra damage. Whatever. Let's equip it. Severed head. I don't even know where I got that from. That's kind of morbid. Do I have the wits to see it? I do not. Is he going to point it out to me? He is. And he points it out to us now. Yeah, alright. So we use our godlike item, the actual god tier item, the shovel, to go down here, grab a few extra XP, 725, I forgot that was so much. we're going to open some barrels. I'm pretty sure we don't have enough strength to free this guy quite yet. However, we might end up being fine as it is. Let's see what we can eat to add strength to us. Let's see. Oh, snap. You just need a 12 strength? Okay. Yeah, there we go. There's a 1200 XP. We take that. We take that 100% of the time. I didn't expect it to work on 12 strength, but you know what? We got it. Obviously, we equipped the Spear of Brachus Rex. I mean... It's just the best item to use currently. There's no other way to put it. We need to loot these a wee bit. Okay. We're going to move them out of the way. We didn't get any luck there, so that's too bad. Alright, we're going to move you out of the way. We're going to move you out of the way. And maybe... What is that? Not enough strength to move this barricade. Alright, whatever. We're going to kill this barricade to death. With our newly found Spear of Brachus Rex. Yeah. Easy. And we're going to... Does this give us XP? If it does, then we're going to take it. If not, then that sucks. It does. We're going to break that so that the water washes away the poison. It's almost like poetry at that point. And we're going to leave. We are almost to the next level. And it is to the point where I'm getting a little bit scared because I don't know where I'm going to get the last few levels from. But I think we may or may not be fine. This guy is going to give us some seeds.
Here you are. We are unfit, so tell me, start from the beginning. I see. Now tell me how your story ends. I see it. Take this rope. It is nothing.
Cool, he's a traitor. We don't have anything that... we don't have any need for any of the wares that he's... No, you know what? I've got to go find the turtles, because the turtles are going to end up giving me a little bit of experience when I entered that part of the beach, aren't they? Bit of a misplay. But what can you do? Sometimes it just happens. I think if we walk forwards, we get a little bit of XP. I'm starting to doubt myself here. There we go. 300 XP. We'll take it. We're obviously not going to be able to fight the crocodiles right now. But what we are going to do is walk away. All right. What do we have? A very small amount of XP to go. I know exactly how to grab it. All right. We have to do the freaking guy on the beach. The guy on the beach storyline. One of my favorite storylines. Is it this way? I don't even remember. No, it's not this way. No, it's somewhere. I mean, it's somewhere. We've gotten that far. Alright. We're gonna find it a little bit better here. Where are we? It's over. Okay, so it's to our right. So it is up here. It's by the cave entrance. Oh yeah, it's over here. Whew. Oh my gosh. Here we go. We found it. Let's go. Let's bring this yarrow flower to this dude and give it to him and reunite him with his daughter, you know, all that mushy gushy stuff. Alright, we're gonna open this crate and see what's inside of it. We're gonna absolutely love the bounds of endless limbs that are over here. We're gonna take this very slowly. Take the yarrow plant, offer it to him. Ask him why he was looking for that. And, alright. We're gonna loot this mutilated corpse. We're gonna loot that mutilated corpse. And this guy is gonna be totally fine with it. Oh, those are some pants. We're gonna go ahead and equip that. Alright, I wonder if we have enough wits to see the thing over here. We do not. We're still down on XP, obviously. We're still down a little over 1,000. I don't even remember if this gives XP, but I really am hoping that it does. Because if it doesn't, then I'm kind of screwed. So let's hope for the best. We just gotta get there and hopefully end up doing well with this. Alright, we're gonna walk past all these people with mommy daddy issues. There's no better way to describe it, but that's what it is. That's exactly what it is. Do this crate. Easy read. Easy read. More recipes. Yeah, I can reach you. Come on. Come on. Don't play with me. Don't tease me, yo. Let's go ahead and talk with Magister Yarrow.
You there, Elf?
Let's barter with her, just in case she ends up dying. You never know.
You have seen him, and you're...
She inspects the room.
Boom! Hero tag. I need a me, because I'm a hero. Woo, woo. I'm literally one of the funniest guys you'll ever meet. And sometimes I just prove it constantly. Alright, we're gonna come there. Woo, we're waiting for this walking. Woo, we're waiting for this walking. How do you like my song? I think it's kind of beautiful. And I'm never gonna think otherwise. It's bringing a tear to my eye just thinking about it. All right. Let's go talk to these people and get my key. Get my key. We say the hero. Oh yeah, 600 XP. We're almost there. We're almost there. I think we take the skull cap. And we equip it. Yeah. Easy. Easy equip. Damn. And we need a very small amount of XP to level up. All right. I think that's a good place to stop it. This is my version of next time on Dragon Ball Z. Basically, will I be able to find out how to level up with having exhausted all of my immediate thoughts? I guess we'll find out next time on Dragon Ball Z. Thanks for watching.